Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls 2 PvP Duels, and today I'm dueling against Mistborn. This fight that you see right here is my first random encounter with him after what I said. You're such a good guy, such a good dueler and very skillful, so let's duel. Yeah, like I said, he's a very good dueler. His skill level is, in my opinion, far over mine. Here I tried out the Partisan, which is a pretty good weapon, especially the R2s. Like in the first Souls game, first Dark Souls game, it's a very wide swing with it, and good to catch people who roll around you. So I'm using my Yojimbo build that I also had in the first Dark Souls, which has the significant Onion Knight helm and black leather setup thing. I almost got him there. He's really low HP, and now look what he does. That was so awesome parry. Not with the Monastery Scimitar, just with skill and perfect timing with the normal scimitar. So GG. Really good fights that I had with him, and this is almost max tier PvP, so if you meet a guy who plays that good without buffing or anything, without Monastery Scimitar, then you have to take the chance and do a few good duels with him. But I did, and in the beginning I got wrecked in every single fight. Later we switched to the church chapel location of Zeldora, and it's a pretty good place to duel there too. And yeah, here you see we both are dueling quite good duels. I use my setup with, in the left hand I got the rapier, the normal rapier and the scimitar. In the right hand I got the chaos blade, the I think the Strakekeeper sword, I think, and sometimes in my other hand swaps. I tried to use different, and that parry, man. Well, over in the Shadow Dagger riposte you can argue, but yeah, can do what you want. It's a duel. We haven't set rules, no dagger riposte or so it's totally fine. As long as he doesn't fish for backstab. That's spam though, that's spam. Here I took out my old whip, because old whips kick ass. Here we had a bit lag, and fair how we get away from each other and then approach again. So here I took the Murakumo, and that follow-up attack, I should have done this earlier, then I could have catched him off guard in the approach, but I kinda didn't know whether or not I should do that. And that combo of him, man, I'm again low on health, while he has 3/4 of his health, and yeah, he got me there to the death. So very good duels. I can really say that he's the best dueler I met so far in Dark Souls 2 PvP. I didn't meet so many duelers, but he's the best one I met and fought so far. No one wrecked my face as often as him. In the end it got a bit better, because I got used to his fighting style, and there it went better for me. But the beginning, like you see here, I got really wrecked. And dead again. So let's get into a bit deeper into the fight. He has the Murakumo, and I the me I have the old whip, and here is the spider's silk, and I switch to a shield because the 200 the Yojimbo PvP, the akimbo style weapon in every hand didn't quite work out against him. Props for him using the Murakumo. It's a very heavy weapon and hard to get hits against dex builds like us, like we both have. And yeah, I kinda also tried out to cancel my attacks later, which worked out pretty well. So now I got him low on health. I thought like, yes, I can do that. I got a hit with a running attack. Now, my few last hits, I have to get this. Come on. Come on. He's open. Didn't reach that. And let's again. Yes. Hit him and let's do the running attack. And he fucking parried me. No. GG, very good. Just, he stood there and waited for me to do this fucking running attack that is telegraphed so hard. He really got the parries on point. But this is the point where you see I... this katana has the shield, get through the shield attack. It's a dark drift. And I, in this point, I didn't use the good ability of the old whip that much, and the spam though. He said to me that the spam wasn't wanted, of course. He wanted to do the guard break, and yeah, I kinda although I kinda parried that just. So that was my first win against him. That 4-hit spam. Though here we swap to the chapel bonfire thing, and yeah, I find him, fight him a bit on that ground. He uses his, what is it, rapier or estoc or something, can't see it from here, really good, but a curved sword of course, and parry! Normally this parry would have been that late, far too late. Here he messaged me then that it was a good parry, but let's continue the fight. Normally this parry would have been far too late of my thing, but it hit him, kinda. I don't know why, but it's just like that. It is what it is, guys. Like Mr. I Won't Forget once likes to say, it is what it is. Here is the turtle poke to for the win. So. Let's see. Now I swapped again to akimbo playstyle, Melu Shimitar and the Varangian sword, and here he hit me with his katana. I haven't used the katana because I know he has the parry timing up to 1000%, and that turtle poke delay. So I kinda wanted to bite him into the sword, shield break attack, and this all these backstab fish animation, as all this backstab fishing wasn't wanted, of course. He's no backstab fisher, and it bothered him that he always the game always wanted him to backstab fish. And so he couldn't do a normal R1 instead. That was kinda downside of this. Here are the two heavy attacks of the whip. Of the old whip. Awesome. Awesome damage. And yeah, I kinda used the bait. This back hop wasn't wanted like that, but anyways. I kinda used the throwables to bait him a bit, to not be responsive, as I could have parried him this his spear attacks here, but again this wasn't a backstab attempt of it. Shouldn't be. He would have hit me with that normal R1, but well, bam, Woohoo! Yay. Yeah, that parry, that rapier parry was wanted, expected, but with these spear parries you have to parry before he even hits the attack, so it was kinda... Yeah. I thought he's gonna do this attack, and at this point I had observed his playstyle quite a bit, so that I could parry him a bit. Or, yeah, I swapped to the katana here, not to the old whip, because that would have one-hitted him, like it has before, almost. Here he again messaged me that I have the parry timing now, but yeah. Just be unpredictable, then it's all okay. Here you see that I have the black steel katana, and I know that I didn't get the guard break here, so I just went with the R1. And yeah, here you also see the... attack cancels of the whip. Zack, that was one. And that again, and running, and bam. Done. So I cannot describe how much fun it was to play against someone who's such a good player and not just buffing all his three buffs, his things that make him totally overpowered, Havel's things and so on. He didn't buff anything and still was such a challenge for me to fight against. And I think I was at skill level a bit under him, even. Wrecked. And yeah, definitely fun. Here I have the infantry axe that I think looks visually very awesome, but its damage is just very low, his reach is not very good. And he with the shotel that I also really like, because it's so unused and so cool. You remind Dark Souls 1, the shotel was the only thing you could do against boom! Parry! And that riposte damage though. Like I said, damage is very low. You remind Dark Souls Dark Souls 1, where the shotel was the only thing you could do against Turtlers. Yeah, no one reminds it now and uses the shotel anymore. I like to use it, but yeah, just because it's uncommon. And the shotel has kinda good average to good damage output. Boom! Infantry axe hits like nothing. I think at least the dagger ones hit more than the infantry axe ones. And here, you saw that, I rolled away from him and with the follow-up rolling attack R1, he turned 180 degrees. That's something that the whips can do really, really well. And I haven't used it that much, but it's very good, very, very good and very unexpected that you just turn around 180 degrees to get the rolling attack in. So definitely something you could do. And like the beginning fights, it has to be that I totally get wrecked in the last fight. Like you see here, I trade hits, what I shouldn't do with the Dark Drift, which looks really awesome, and I get almost wrecked there. So GG to Mistborn, and if you want to duel me, just contact me on Steam or YouTube, and I see you all next time.